Who are you and from which organization are you?
My name is Lorenzo Serna. I'm from Unicorn Riot in the United States. We're a horizontally organized media organization, a 501c3 nonprofit, and we have no bosses. Our organization is completely horizontal and we operate by consensus. So I'm in the Hambach Forest in Germany. And right now, all around, there's occupations up in the trees. People are trying to hold this space from an encroaching coal mine that's been destroying this forest over time. And what they've told us is this is a very old growth forest, that this sort of like mixture of trees are all here together. It doesn't really exist anywhere else. And so they want to defend that. And what they're defending is basically what's left. And then if we're able to see over to this mine, supposedly this forest, from my understanding, went across this whole area. And we're sitting in a 1 kilometer by 2 kilometer spot. That's the last of it. And so they're doing their best to kind of defend it. Even in northern Minnesota, where I'm from, there's the Line 3 pipeline fight. There was a group of activists who went and turned off valves in Minnesota and to stop tar sands from going through. And their charges were dropped. Great. That's really, really exciting. But there's also Native American activists who went and they locked down, and they were charged, found guilty, and faced restitution to pay back money for what they did. And so in the United States, there's a lot of like race issues as well that play out within these movements. And you have a lot of like people who are able to engage and even be push a little more, who usually are like European Americans, you know, and then the indigenous people there, when they try to organize, as they've been facing for 500 years, this face immense repression. Barack Obama, you know, was a different president than we had Trump. But obviously I was in Standing Rock when Trump was elected. I was in like the casino just down the street watching the numbers roll in, and you know, right after that, it just all changed. I mean, it was like before there was at least these legal frameworks and ideas of like, you know, when you're going to put these pipelines through, you have to go through these different processes and all these things that have been created to like, you know, make it okay. And that just kind of went away now. It seems like Trump's view of everything is like pro-fossil fuel, and anything that stands in the way of making these things is a problem. And so they're pushing through all this stuff. And at the same time, they're creating more and more laws to protect those pipelines. And there's like in South Dakota, there's a law that they passed. It's called a riot boosting law. And basically, they can be used against anybody who's in South Dakota asking people to come protest. You know, so like Standing Rock, indigenous people ask people to come protest. You know, they're like, please come stand with us, da 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 da. And basically they're saying that if the groups who are saying that are causing a riot and can be charged with felonies and up to 20 years in prison for just telling people to come. Right now I feel like we live in this moment where it's just like an international movement to save the earth is probably, it exists and it's important, and it needs to speak to each other more and coalesce into whatever it's going to be. You know, like Extinction Rebellion began in London, and then you saw sort of pockets of that sort of spread in the United States. And so like now Fridays for the Future is sort of spreading there. I was on a youth climate march, you know, and they referenced it, you know. So like students are getting active, and everyone's sort of getting active, and it's great, but it's also kind of sad, you know. I was speaking to this woman who was talking about, I mean, she was 16, I think. She was 15 or 16. I was speaking to this person, and they're like, yeah, I'm worried about my 8-year-old, the future for my 8-year-old sister. And I'm like, wow, like you're 15, 16, this is what you're worried about, you know? And it's ridiculous that this is where we are, where like the children are trying to save the adults and trying to save the future for whatever kids may come, you know? And so it's spreading. People are speaking to each other. Ideas are always there. But like I said, the United States right now is in such turmoil that I don't know what energy coalesces where when there's so much that people are trying to like address and do, and so I don't know. It's just people are very scattered, and I would say probably like a little demoralized. You know, like it's been very traumatic right now to be in the United States. What do we want to look back at and be proud of? And I hope it's not this fucking mine.